Welcome in the class of Water Resource Engineering. Today we are going to see the canals. I am Mr. Sisogule, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department. So basically, what are the canals? So canals or canal is defined as an artificial channel constructed on the ground to carry water from river to another canal or reservoir to the fields. So what are the classification of canals? So classification based on alignments. That is contour canal, that is not the ridge, that is the contour canal. This is contour canal. Contour canal. Second is ridge canal. And third is side long or side slope canal. The classification based on position, that is main canal, branch canal, major distributary, minor distributary, water course and head work. So contour canal. When canals are to be laid in a hilly area, it is not possible to align along which it is at the top of the hill. In such cases, canals are aligned generally along the contours. The canal taking off from reservoir follows the contour alignment such that canal which is aligned parallel to the contours of area is known as a contour canal. The contour canal have a large number of cross drainage works but no faults. Contour canal can irrigate only one side of the ground level as another side is quite high. So as you can we can think, this is suppose the contour line, that is kind of hills. So it is something like this. These contour lines are there. So canal is passing through along one contour like this. So on this higher side it is not possible to irrigate, but on lower side it is easy to irrigate that particular area. The contour canal need not follow the same contour along its length. To contour canals, longitudinal slope is given to enable the water to flow by gravity. So obviously in canal we allow to flow with the gravity. So slightly slope has been given, so it is going to change the contours after some distance to provide the force or flow the water with the gravity. So here you can see, this is cross drain work and this is the contour canal. So these are the contours and these are the tributary ridge canals. These are the cross drainage work. This is the contour canal. This is the weir through which water is flowing. And this is river. So this is the contour canal through which water is flowing. Now what are the advantages? So it is suitable in hilly areas. Second is to contour canal, longitudinal slope is given to enable the water flow by gravity. So it is possible to give the slope longitudinally for the better flow. Now what are the disadvantages? So large number of cross drainage works are needed. As here you can see, water tends to flow. These are the contour lines. These are the contour lines. So obviously water tends to flow by gravity in this direction and we are taking canal in this direction. So always there are some cross drains in between. So that is the case. And it can irrigate only one side. Now second is the ridge canal or ridge alignment. So it is called as a watershed canal. This type of canal are generally laid along the ridge or a naturally watershed line. As canal runs on the watershed, it can irrigate both side of the canal. So these canals are very economical. No cross drain works are required. So as here you can see, this is a kind of ridge canal. So all other flows are flowing in this direction, so no CD work is needed and it can irrigate the both sides of the canal. So here you can see, this is the ridge line and canal flow or following this ridge line. So sometimes drainage is there but no need to require that CD work. So what are the advantages? It can irrigate both sides. It is economical because we have the natural water flow in that particular region. Then no CD work is required. Then what are the disadvantages? the velocity of water needs to be controlled because we have the natural slope, so it is not in our hand to control the velocity of water. So we have to make the arrangement to control the velocity of water. Then scouring bed is due to higher velocity. So obviously you might have seen there are so many flows in rainy season in our countries, or particularly in the Ghats. So after that water drains out, so you can see there is so much erosion or scouring of bed due to this higher velocity falls. Now side slope canals. In this type of alignment, canal is not aligned along either ridge or contour, but it is aligned across contour. These canals run nearly parallel to natural drain, similar to the contour canal. It also irrigates the area on only one side. These type of canal are not intercepted by the cross drainage works. So now what are the difference between these things? So contour canal and ridge canal. So in contour canal, it follows the contour, and in ridge canal, it follows highest or predominant ridge in command. Then second is, the main canal is usually provided in its head ridge near reservoir as a contour canal. In this thing, main canal is usually provided and the its lower ridge, and all other canals are canals as a ridge canal. It has number of cross drainage work, it has less number of cross drainage work. It does not have falls. These canal falls are more as canal bed gradient is flatter than natural bed. Then the irrigated only one side of the canal, it irrigates both sides. This is 50% efficient, this is best and more efficient. This leads to more seepage, it leads to less seepage. It is has more length, more loss of the land. It has less loss of cultivable area as land at the ridge is of poor quality, because erosion is there, that's why it is of poor quality. Now this is the canal network. Here you can see this is the reservoir, this is the main river, this is the river stream, and these are the contour canals. So these are the head regulators and cross regulators. That things we are going to see. This is basically the canal network, how the canal flows. This is the ridge canal, this is the contour canal, is flow along with the contour, and this is along with the ridge, and these are the drains works and outlets are there. So this way this canal works and network works. Now what are the parts of the canal system? So in canal system, main canal is there, branch canal is there, then major distributor, minor distributor, and water courses are there. So here you can see, this is the river, this is the head regulator, this is the diversion work. So these are the branch canal, this is the main canal, these are the branch canals, these are the minor distributaries and major distributaries. So likewise, the work has been done in the canal system. So main canal, the canal taking off from the river or the reservoir, that is from the source, is called as a main canal. The function is to carry the total water and to distribute it to the canal system. It is the largest canal in the system, and no direct irrigation is normally done from the main canal. Then the branch canal, it is the canal takes off from the main canal on either side. Very little direct irrigation is done from them. These canals act as a feeder canal to the major distributaries. The discharge capacity of branch canal is usually varies from 5 to 25 cubic. It helps to irrigation water available in different parts of the distribution. Now major distributor, it generally takes off from the main canal, which supplies water to the other distributor. The discharge capacity of major distributor varies from 0.25 to 5 cubic. In some cases it may be 10 cubic. These are generally used for direct irrigation, and the main function is to distribute water to the water courses. Then minor distributors or miners. Minor distributor generally takes off from the major distributor or main canals or another distributor and supplies water to the water course. It has discharge capacity less than 0.25 cubic. These are also used in a direct irrigation. Water courses, these are small channels which takes water from the outlet of the distributor or minor distributor and supply to it the agriculture field. In our local language, we call it as a PAT. So these are owned, constructed, controlled and maintained by the cultivator, that is by farmers. Sometimes these are constructed by the government on behalf of irrigator, but its maintenance is carried out by irrigators only. Now the head work. The works, those are constructed to store, divert and control the river water, regulate the supply to the canal, is called as a head work. So here you can see these are the water courses and these are the fields. So by which water will reach to the field. Now there are few small things, that is these controller things. So we will discuss these things later on in detail, but right now I will give a small hint of these things. The head regulator. When the canals are branched or taking off from the reservoir or main canals in the distribution system, the head regulator is provided at head of the canal to divert necessary discharge from the reservoir to canal or main canal to branch canal, to control, regulate or measure the discharge, to control the silt entry in taking off canal, to stop the supply of the water when not needed at the end of rotation, or for repair at downstream, these head regulators has been used. Cross regulators, when it is required to raise the water level in the main canal in order to regulate the flow in branch canal, to stop the flow in case of repair on downstream, to divert the silty overflow of water in it into the nearby river or stream during the flood control, cross regulator is provided. Escape. At the end of main canal, or to allow escape of the silty water into the west channel and then to the natural drain during rainy season, escapes are provided. Outlets, to admit the water into distributaries, minors, water courses, field channels, etc., the outlets has been provided. So in today's lecture, actually all the things are not related with the syllabus, but those are necessary to learn or to know. So keep the things in mind, even though they are not in the syllabus. So references for today's lectures are www.slideshare.net, then the book of Irrigation Engineering and Hydraulic Structure by S.K. Garg. Thank you.